Namaste children. Hi. Let us discuss 14th lesson. In 10th class social studies is the war between wars. 1900 and 1950 part 2. What were the incident took place in the war between 1900 and 1950 that we are going to discuss in this lesson. In this session we are going to discuss about rise of Stalin. The last session we discussed about Russian Socialist Revolution. In this session, we are going to discuss about rise of Stalin, USSR. After the death of Lenin in the year 1924, Joseph Stalin became the leader of Communist Party and became the ruler of USSR. USSR full form is Union of Soviet Socialist Republic. His aim is to strengthen the economy of USSR. His aim is to build the economy of USSR. To strengthen the economy of USSR, Joseph Stalin introduced 5-year plans in Russia. Okay, who is the first person introduced 5-year plans in the world? Joseph Stalin. Which country was the first country to introduce 5-year plans in the world? USSR. USSR was the first country to introduce 5-year plans in the world. And Joseph Stalin was the person who introduced 5-year plans in the world. To strengthen the economy of USSR, Joseph Stalin introduced 5-year plans. Under 5-year plans, he introduced twin policy. He introduced twin policy called collectivization of agriculture and rapid industrialization. Collectivization of agriculture and rapid industrialization. The idea of collectivization and agricultural policy is to produce agriculture production large scale. The idea of collectivization of agriculture policy is to produce agriculture production in large scale. Under this collectivization of agriculture policy, Joseph Stalin wanted to end the small farmers' production and he forced small farmers and large farmers to surrender the land along with tool, machine and animals. Under this policy, all the farmers in the village should work collectively together, till the land and produce the crop. And the produce should be divided among the village farmers equally. And the surplus production be sold in the foreign market and earn profit and make an economy of USSR. This was the idea of collectivization of agriculture policy. When Joseph Stalin tried to implement this policy, small farmers returned the land to government. Small farmers returned the land to the government, whereas large farmers didn't return the land to the government. And they stopped cultivating the crop. When thousands of large farmers didn't return the land to the government and stopped cultivating, food became shortage, crop became shortage. When food became shortage, famine took place. A severe famine took place in Russia between 1929 and 1930. Millions of people in Russia, without getting food to eat, they died with starvation. When many people died of starvation without getting food to eat, Joseph Stalin got angry on the thousands of large farmers. Again, he ordered the thousands of large farmers to return the land to government. The farmers who denied to give the land to the government were imprisoned, were deported, were executed. Executed means killed. By giving this kind of sorts of punishment, large farmers got fear and they had to return the land to the government. After small farmers and large farmers surrendered the land to government along with tool, machine, animals, now Joseph Stalin implemented this characterization of agricultural policy. After implementing this characterization of agricultural policy, all the farmers in the village collectively till their land, produced crop. Now agriculture production rose into high level. when agriculture production increased, now the Russian government, USSR government divided the crop produce for all the village farmers equally, and remaining surplus agriculture productions are sold in the foreign market. They earn enormous profit, and by this, from agriculture, USSR economy was developed. But from agriculture, USSR strengthened their economy. When agriculture production rose into high peak, this helped to develop industries in Russia. This helped to develop industries in unprecedented scale. Unprecedented means in unimaginable scale, the agriculture was developed. The income, the profit, the income, the economy gained by USSR from agriculture, that income, that profit, that economy was invested in industries to develop in Russia. Thus, industries were developed in unprecedented scale. All the industries in USSR are owned under the state. All the industries in Russia are under the control of government, in which the produce are not sold in the market for the consumer directly. It will be sold in the sold for the people through government store. The first industry set up in Russia was steel factory at Magnitogorsk. The first factory set up in Russia was steel factory set up at Magnitogorsk. Setting this factory took 3 years. Do you know why, children? The place has severe climatic condition. The climatic condition is very bad in Magnitogorsk. During winter season, the temperature at Magnitogorsk is below 40 degrees Celsius. Children, you imagine, if the temperature is 0 degrees Celsius, the water is becoming ice. Whereas in Magnitogorsk, the temperature is below 40 degrees Celsius. Below 40 degrees Celsius means, okay, you imagine how the climatic conditions be. If the climatic condition is below 40 degrees Celsius, nervous gets struck. We can't move the fingers, hands and legs. We get body aches. We get fever, cold, cough, everything. And we cannot, at that time, we cannot eat the food also. In that condition, we cannot even move the finger also. In that condition, the workers should set up this factory. Is it possible, children? It's impossible. Even though the climatic condition is very bad, the workers lived in hot leaves and set up this factory. Though the climatic condition is very bad, they stopped setting this factory for 550 times at Magnitogorsk. To go for Tyler, the workers should climb from 4th floor to down floor, and you should cross the road, and they have to go for toilet. In winter season, temperature is below 40. In below 40 degrees Celsius, the worker should climb from 4th floor to down floor, and should cross the road and go for toilet. How hard it is! The temperature is below 40 means how hard it is. The blood in our body can clot. It is very dangerous for the person. The climatic condition is very, very bad for the people to live. Because it means the blood in the body can clot due to the temperature. Okay, at that temperature, in the severe climate, workers live very hotly and set up this factory. At last, it took 3 years to complete this factory. After completing setting this factory, USSR government gave jobs for many people and the standard of living was increased. Not only set up this factory, like this factory, USSR government set up more and more and provided employment for many people in USSR. Joseph Stalin introduced some reforms for the welfare of the people. Joseph Stalin introduced reforms for the welfare of the people. To improve the standard of living of the people, to make the people to live in dignity life, to make the people to respectful life, dignity life, to improve the standard of living, Joseph Stalin introduced welfare reforms for the people. What are they? Joseph Stalin, he introduced first reform is he extended schooling system. He developed schooling system. That means he set up many schools for the children and gave free education. Thus private education developed in USSR and literacy was increased. Joseph Stalin not only set up a school for children and gave free education, he also set up universities for the peasant workers, for the peasants and industrial workers to study in universities to improve the literacy rate. Joseph Stalin arranged crutches. Crutches means baby care center. Joseph Stalin arranged crutches means baby care center for the children of working women. Joseph Stalin provided health facility, hospital facility for the people at more cheap rate, for less rate. Joseph Stalin provided living quarters, it means houses, for the workers. Joseph Stalin set up more and more factories and gave more employment for the citizens. By that, the standard of living of the Russians were increased. We all will know, Great Depression took place in the year 1929 that we discussed in 13th lesson. Due to Great Depression took place in the year 1929, factories got heavy loss, industries got heavy loss, factories shut down, industries shut down, millions of workers lost their job. The agriculture production, the price of the agriculture crop has become very low. The farmers got severe loss. This what happened to the time of Great Depression impacted all over the world. Whereas Great Depression does not impact on USSR. Great Depression affected, created effect throughout all the countries in the world. Great Depression impacted all the countries in the world. Whereas Great Depression does not create an effect on USSR. Great Depression does not create an impact on USSR. Why? Why? Because means USSR was not associated with the international market. USSR was not integrated, didn't keep relationship with international market. And USSR had a planned economy. USSR had a planned economy that state, how much should be produced, what should be produced, decided by the state. US had a planned economy that state would decide how much should be produced, what should be produced. This enabled to maintain balance between demand and supply. Because of this reason, Great Depression didn't impact on Russia. Great Depression did not create an effect on USSR. Whereas Great Depression created effect, it created impact throughout all the countries in the world. The Great Depression took place in all the countries in the world except USSR. Factories, industries shut down, millions of people lost their jobs, and the price of agriculture crop became very less, the farmers got severe loss. This thing didn't happen in USSR. Why? Because Great Depression didn't impact on USSR. The ideals of USSR were inspired all over the world. Children, do you know what were the famous ideals inspired all over the world? Equality and national liberation were the Russian ideals inspired all over the world. Equality and national liberation, these are the Russian ideals were inspired all over the world. All the people in the world, all the countries in the world inspired the Russian ideals like equality and national liberation. Many large numbers, they became communists and they want to bring communist revolution in their countries. Especially our country leaders like Emmanuel Roy, Tagore, Nehru. They were the Indian leaders inspired the Russian ideas like equality and national liberations. Though they inspired Russian ideas like equality and national liberation, they didn't like some aspects of communism. Our Indian leaders, though they like the Russian ideas like equality and national liberation, they didn't like some aspects of communism like denial of freedom or liberty. That means the Russian government won't give any freedom or any liberty to the citizen. Okay, not in Russia. Any country who set up a communist government, in such countries, government did not give freedom or did not give any liberty to the citizens. So, yes, Russia is a communist country. Russian free people, Russian citizen didn't enjoy any freedom or any liberty. The second aspect didn't like by our Indian leaders was denial of multi-party democracy. During the time of election, the ruling party will contest election. If opposing party contests election against ruling party, the ruling party will suppress the opposing party violently. So these aspects did like by our Indian leaders like Hemant Roy, Gaurav Nehru. So then, class question now, what were the again aspects of communism did like by our Indian leaders like Hemant Roy, Gaurav Nehru? What means Russian, as Russia is a communist country, Russian government didn't give freedom for the citizens. Second one is multi-party democracy was not there in Russia. What is multi-party democracy? During election time, when ruling party comes election, even opposition party also should contest election. Whereas in Russia, during time of election, ruling party only comes election. Suppose if opposition party contests election, the ruling party will suppress the opposition party violently. So these things, these aspects of communism were not liked by our Indian leaders like Hemant Roy, Tagore and Nehru. George Orwell is a famous novelist. He wrote a satire novel. Called Animal Farm. In that novel, he highlighted the Russian ideas were compromised to USSR. George Orwell, he wrote a satire novel called Animal Farm to highlight the Russian ideas were compromised to USSR. Do you know what's the meaning for that? George Orwell says, the ideals of Russia, the ideals of our country, means Russia. George Orwell says, he wrote a book called Novel Animal Farm. In his book, he explained, all the countries in the world were inspiring the Russian ideals, like equality, national liberation. Actually, because of these ideals followed by Russia, our peoples are put into problems. About that, he explained in his book. Once again, children, George Orwell, he wrote a satire novel called Animal Farm to highlight the Russian ideas that compromised USA. What is the meaning for that? He wrote in his book, George Orwell, he wrote in his book called Animal Farm. In that book, he explained that Russian ideas were inspired all the countries in the world. But because of following the Russian ideas by our Russian peoples are put into problems. Children, so far we discussed about the rise of Stalin, how Stalin came to power. To strengthen the economy of USSR, what were the policy he introduced? To increase the standard of living of the people, what were the reforms he introduced? More that we discussed. Okay, if Stalin introduced all these reform means, why? Because you know, Stalin introduced many reforms for the welfare of the people to increase the standard of living. How is it possible for Stalin? Because Stalin is just having enormous centralization of power. And discuss about the ideals of Russia. We discuss about George Orwell also, what satire novel he wrote. Okay, one of the boy asked a doubt, sir, why communist country didn't give freedom for, why communist country didn't give freedom to the citizen? Why, sir, though they gave equality for all the people in Russia, why they didn't give freedom to the citizen, sir? Why they suppress multi-party democracy, sir? Why they suppress opposition party, sir, by killing many people? One of the boy asked a doubt, let me explain. Why? Because means, to defeat capitalism power, to build socialism, they did all these aspects. To defeat capitalism, to build socialism, communist country like Russia follow these aspects. These aspects did like by Hemant Roy, Gaurav Nehru of a great Indian leaders. Children, I hope you understand this concept. Again, see these videos repeatedly by keeping textbook in front of you so that you can understand very much better. Otherwise, we'll teach you this lesson in the class session in detail. Then we can clarify the doubts very clearly, children. Thank you, children.
Bağışlar.